Hey guys, I wanted to show some of the techniques I've been working recently. I've been working the Meregali sweep a lot, which is like the deep lasso with the foot under the butt sweep that Meregali made popular over the last few years. So I'm just going to share some of my favorite variations. Okay, so the basic idea of the sweep, if you guys have ever seen it, it's these sweep variations where you get a deep lasso, but your foot goes under the butt to bump the guy overhead. So it looks pretty simple, but there's a lot of details in the setup to make it work. So I'm gonna show my three favorite setups in a couple variations, okay? So the first setup I really like to use is from this far side collar sleeve position. So you can get here in different ways. Maybe I have the ankle and I get this far sleeve because he tries to grab my leg. I put the foot in the bicep and I start playing the far side collar sleeve. I have a video on this. Here, you know, you can attack triangles, blah, blah, blah. It's a very common position to go to. You could also set it up in like lasso spider. I break past the body here, go far side collar sleeve. So we're attacking here, right? So a lot of times when you go here, the guy will kind of lead with this right leg a bit. He has that left leg back, right? And I'm attacking and they'll frame on your ribs like this really hard, okay? And when they frame on the ribs here, it makes it hard to attack the far side because they can't lift my body into the guy. Okay, so you'll often see Meregali and Tommy Langenkirk playing this position a lot here where they're attacking, and guys will do this, and they have different defenses. One thing Meregali does a lot that I've been using a lot recently is when I feel like I'm stuck here, I switch this hand that's on the cross collar to the same side collar grip, okay? So we're here, I get this high collar grip, and now with this leg forward, I can swing my left belly heave hook in. Once I swing this left belly heave hook in, it kind of keeps him locked forward with this leg. It makes it hard for him to get away. As soon as I do this, again, I want a really high collar grip. I pull, and now I'm gonna take this leg out and shoot deep to the lasso, and I'm gonna lock my foot right under his tailbone. Okay, you can go around the backside to get that. Okay, so I lock my right foot just under his tailbone. When I take this left foot out, I'm gonna tap the floor, and I wanna both pull myself into him and center up like this. This makes it easier to take him overhead. If I go too sideways, don't do it, but he can start passing this way, right? So we're gonna try to center up like this and drive off the floor to get the lift, okay? And of course, when I actually do this, I'm gonna be very fast about it. Now, there's a couple different variations on the finish. We're just gonna keep it simple. I try to lift. If you do it fast and use this elbow, you can usually block him from posting the hand and you get this nice flip, okay? And there's a lot of different things you could do. You could hook here and come up. I could try to turn this into like an almost throttle position by re-rolling. There's different things like that. I'm not gonna get so into that right now, okay? The basic idea, again, is we're here, we have this far side collar sleeve grip, he's blocking the rib, I feel kind of stuck. We switch to the near side collar. I swing this near daily hook in, loop in, tap the floor, and go, okay? Now, another thing that can happen is sometimes when I start trying to take him here, he starts sliding out this way for like a folding pass and coming to his knees, right? So as he goes here, you feel there's no more sweep here, it's really hard. But it's also really hard for him to pass because I can frame his cross face with his left arm. So I start coming up on my elbow here, right? So once I start coming up my elbow, I go up like this, guys will start kind of driving back into you and it's really easy to get a hold of his tricep now. From here all the way from standing, I'm gonna do the same sweep again. I just put my foot in between the legs, I drop center and I flip like this. You get a really nice throw. And again, I can hook my leg under, come up on top, I can try to take side,
re-roll for the omoplata, however you wanna build from there.
Okay, I'm gonna show two more setups I really like for this one. This next one, I've been using a lot recently as well because I like to play double sleeve a lot. Shane Jamil uses these kind of double sleeve variations really well. So I'll have this lasso double sleeve kind of game going on. And a lot of times, keep that elbow tight to me. Yeah, I'm trying to play like a deal, a heave a hook, push the hook, hip out, take it backwards, overhead sweeps, this classic game. But what guys will do a lot in modern jiu-jitsu is they'll crowd with this other leg so he stands kind of close. That makes it harder to get the deal, a heave a hook because he's very square, right? And it's harder to play that traditional game, it's harder to push this hip out. So what I do is when I have this leg past the body position, is now kind of similar to the other one, I'm gonna attack the deal evil hook on the opposite side. It's kind of confusing to them. That locks him in position. Now this left foot goes under the butt. My right foot's gonna tap the floor just like before. I go here, I kind of forward trip in. I bump with this and I tuck his arms down low. He's gonna flip here. If I need extra bonus, I can't quite get him, I'll kick right in the butt with this right foot here. So I drive, can't quite get it, and I tap here, and we get that nice flip. Again, I like to pull here, hook under the leg, and try to come up into this position here, which can easily turn into the re-roll omoplata or whatever you want. Okay, one more time. So we're here, we've got the double sleeve game going, like this. Okay, he's close without the leg, so it's hard to kind of push the hip out. I have the lasso here, maybe. So then I just deal a heave a hook on the far side, go through, tap the floor, center up, bump, kick, and get the flip. Okay, last one. This is one that I came up with that works really well for me in the gym. It's very tricky. I haven't seen anyone else use it. So we're gonna be here, it's gonna be on this side. So what I do in this case is if I just have a normal lasso, and he's kind of forward with this leg just a little bit, it's very hard to do this Meregali sweep here, right? Go lapel, just the angle's really bad for it, right? So I need to be on the other side. So what I do is I use the combination of I'm looking for this sleeve. If he gives me this sleeve, then I can do a lot of other stuff. And a lot of guys will hide this sleeve once you get a good lasso. So when he starts hiding this, I'll use this right leg to butterfly hook real quick to grab his pants, okay? You can grab the ankle too. I like the pants often because it's hard to get to the ankle and they can step off the ankle sometimes. So I get the pant just to hold him in position. Now I'm gonna push on the hip like this, just enough to make him step that leg back, and I pull my hip in. Now my foot goes under the butt, and then now right here, it's very powerful to pull him. I don't even need the lapel or anything. I just let go and start pulling like this, and right about here, he's gonna start looking to post his hand on the floor. I know that. So as he starts to go, I just try to catch it as he goes, and I get the same flip motion, and we go for the same sequence, okay? One more time. Right, we're here, I got this lasso, he's hiding this, I can't quite get it. My butterfly hook here, grab this guy, center in, I wanna get really close, right? This sweep won't work if you're far, I don't have the lift. So I'm using this as a way to kind of pull myself in close. Right there, I'm really close, I start driving, I'm gonna try to catch this, okay? If for whatever reason you try one of these sweep variations with a lapel or this, and he does post the hand really well, it's very easy to use this to set up going to X guard, single leg X, anything like this. If you're gonna do the ankle lock series, I can use this here to hit my ankle lock, and I can build a lot off of that. Okay, so again, you know, I've been out for a little bit. I've been having a lot of stuff going on with the gyms I was training at and stuff, so I'm getting more settled again. I'm gonna be doing a video soon on how to break down video study, so I just wanna make sure I have that's a very important video I wanna make, so I wanna make sure I have all the right editing tools to do it and stuff. If you guys have any questions, let me know. Follow me on Instagram at JohnThomasBJJ, as well as look out for a technique video from this guy in the future, Lucas Galvisera. Is that saying it right? Okay, yeah, he's my friend visiting me from Argentina. He's got a world-class guard, so we'll work on some technique. Probably next week or this week, we'll do some lapel stuff, and we'll see whatever he wants to do. Okay, guys, thanks a lot, as always. And if you guys like the content, the best way to help is always like, share, subscribe. Thanks a lot.